Please, enter.
We welcome your presence, Sen Mithrarin. Preparations for war are nearly complete.
Surely you have more soldiers than this.
General Gaius is nothing if not thorough. His forces have exterminated most Moonbloods from this land. We are all that's left.
How do you expect to win with so few soldiers?
We cannot. That's why we created Sen Mithrarin. You dust will turn the tide.
Well, no pressure or anything.
Yeah. Does General Gaius know of this place?
I fear he does now.
What? How?
One of our own has been keeping an eye on you since your travels began. A merchant, Sereth.
Aha! I knew that creepy merchant was one of you guys!
How did a Moonblood operate so freely in the Wildlands?
He is a smart businessman. Deals in all the right places. Gaius's soldiers turn their gaze from him in exchange for free goods. However, no amount of bribery could cover up that Sereth was helping you to find us.
And that's how Gaius found out. How much time do you think we have to prepare?
Not long, I'm afraid. The whole purpose of Gaius's campaign is to wipe us from the face of this world. Once he knows of our final stronghold, he will send everything he has and destroy us.
I see all sorts of lamps here, but no fire. Is this the way of the Flameless Light?
It is, yes. In ancient times, the Moonbloods went by another name. We lived in a great society called the Sintuck, and we wielded the knowledge to follow the way of the Flameless Light.
Settle in, Dust. This could take a while.
We Sintuck harnessed a power unlike any this world had ever seen. We built elaborate contraptions like these lamps, capable of piercing the darkness without so much as a spark.
Well, obviously something went wrong, because we still have to build a fire every time Dust pulls out his map.
Unfortunately, the ancient tomes do not say how the Sintuck fell, and that knowledge has been lost. Perhaps intentionally. All we know is that our kind were made as outcasts, and that has remained true for countless generations. For the longest time, we believe the Moonbloods were the only ones left who know of the way of the Flameless Light. But we were wrong. When General Gaius began his purge, there were stories of their weapons. Stories of elaborate contraptions that seemed to defy the natural world. Weapons that sound identical to those of the Sintuck in the most ancient of tales.
What kinds of weapons are we talking about?
Arrows made of light. Machines that take to the sky like birds.
And we're supposed to fight these things with your lamps.
I did not say it would be easy.
Nobody ever does.
I did once, remember?
Yeah, and you were wrong.
Well, I'm here now. Is there anything I can do to help?
We are spread rather thin. Our chief engineer, Sonjin, is having trouble with our camp's support systems. Go and speak with him when you can, and I'm sure he will explain further. There is also the matter of our scout, Kier. He is not checked in for many hours. But with our battle preparations, we have not been able to mobilize a proper search party. His patrol takes him east of our camp if you aim to find him.
Ginger?
Jin? Oh, Dust. It's you.
Yeah, just me. Are you all right?
I'll be fine. Just a lot to think about.
Listen, about Jin.
Yes?
What was he like?
He was very kind. Almost to a fault, really.
I like him already.
Yes, he had that effect on people. I like to believe it's what made you do all those wonderful things for Aurora and Mudpot.
Aro was always testing me. Every time I made a choice, he would tell me if it was the right one. I was choosing whether to follow Jin or Cassius. I believe they were both trying to influence my actions.
And you listened to Jin?
Yeah, he's kinda hard to ignore.
He is, isn't he? Or at least he was.
No, Ginger. I think you were right the first time. I think Jin continues to live through my actions. He's guiding me, keeping me on the right path.
But what of your other half? Cassius murdered my family, Dust. He destroyed my village, killed my friends. How can you control such a terrible being?
I feel his presence every time I swing the blade of Ara. I believe the Elder was right. Without him, I'd have been cut down long ago. But Jin keeps him from taking control.
As long as Cassius lives within you, though, there's always that danger. You could always be pulled to a path of evil.
I won't lie. I felt him pulling me to take the quick and easy path, to leave the weak to fend for themselves, to show no mercy to those in my way.
Perhaps someday you can be rid of his foul presence.
Maybe. Someday. For now, I need him to defeat Gaius. There's no other way.
I know. Still, I'm glad we were able to talk, Dust.
Me too, Ginger. I'll be back before you know it.
Be careful.
Mithrarin, do you need anything else?
Thank you, Elder, but I must be on my way.
Yes, much to do. Less and less time to do it. Good luck.
Ah, you've arrived just in time, Mithrarin. My name is Sanjin. I'm what you'd call a chief engineer, I suppose the term is.
The Elder mentioned you needed some help?
Yes, indeed. In the caverns below, we've set up machinery to provide the camp with power and water. Unfortunately, seismic activity has shut down both systems, so we need to get them running once more. I have been rather preoccupied handling the battle preparations, so if you could, I would appreciate it if you went down there to examine the generators.
Sure, Sanjin. I'll take a look.
Thank you. You'll need to restart the generator and water pump when you're down there. We'll require both systems to be running if we're going to stand a chance against General Gaius.
The generator. Let's see if we can find a way to get it working again.
I sense no energy emanating from the device, Dust. Perhaps there is a way to return its spark? Well done, Fidget. The camp should now be receiving power.
Honestly, Fidget, where would I be without you?
Probably still be wandering around in the mountains outside Aurora.
Wait, what?
What I meant to say was, don't worry about it. Well, this is the water pump. Huh, no wonder it stopped. These vines are growing all over it.
I don't want to risk damaging the pump trying to cut those vines. Maybe there's some way we can burn them off? The generator and the water pump back online. Let's return to Sanjin.
Excellent work, Mithrarin. Now that the power and water systems are working again, we can hold our ground against Gaius' soldiers. You have saved many lives this day. Excellent work.
Mithrarin, do you need anything else?
Thank you, Elder.
Thank you.
Elder, I'm afraid I have bad news. We found Kier, but he was ambushed by Gaius' soldiers. He didn't stand a chance.
Then it has already begun. Dust, we are nearly out of time. Please, help Sonjin get our camp support systems working once again. Without them, we will stand little chance of mounting an effective defense.
It sounds like Sonjin was able to get the pumps and generators working again.
No doubt thanks to your help. With power and water flowing through our camp once again, we will be better equipped to handle our enemies in battle and properly tend to our wounded. Thank you, Dust. I believe we are as prepared as we possibly could be. With the enemy at our gates, we have no choice but to begin our assault. Our warriors are gathering at the edge of the camp, waiting for you to lead them. Take this yellow resonance gem, Dust. Use it to open the gate.
Thank you, Elder, for everything.
Whatever happens, Senmithrarin, know that I am honored to have stood before you. The Moonbloods will follow you unto death. Now go, and Dust, good luck.
Thank you. seems my secret is out, yes?
It honestly wasn't that much of a secret.
So, you were keeping watch on us this whole time?
In a manner of speaking, just making sure you were well supplied for the journey.
Well, we appreciate the help.
I am glad, my friend. Anything you need, you just let me know.
There, the warriors are gathering.
Ah, Mithrarin. Superb timing. As you can see, our path out of the camp is blocked. Some manner of rock slide. Very unpredictable.
Yes, that happens sometimes when you build your village in a volcanic wasteland.
Anyway, we will need to clear this obstruction before we can exit the camp.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
Well done! Let us begin our assault. We're right behind you, Sanmith Rauren.
Thank you. a Mithrarin.
Please, Dust is fine.
Well, Dust, we got this teleporter up and running just a few moments ago. If you have any business elsewhere, now is the time to do it. Once the charge begins, there's no turning back.
I understand. Thank you, my friend.
Mithrarin, we can't go on any further. Those enemy cannons are far too powerful. You'll need to find a way around their flanks so you can destroy them.
are nearly there, Mithrarin. Once we are through their line, General Gaius will be within sight.
No matter what happens, my friend, it has been an honor to fight by your side.
Your transaction is most appreciated.
Thank you.
I am your trans. Watch your.
Well, that made absolutely no sense.
Every moment has a purpose, Fidget. You just have to dig deeper.
I am here to serve.
Wait! Wait! Just a moment. Lower your weapons. I said lower your weapons!
You have much to answer for, General.
And what of you, my friend? A year ago I heard stories of your death, at the hands of a child, no less. Now here you stand, not only alive, but leading the very creatures we've been charged to destroy.
You've been charged to destroy, not me.
What happened to you, Cassius?
Cassius?
Do you not remember your own name? What have those damned moonbloods done to you?
What did you call me?
Cassius! That's who you are!
Don't listen to him! You're Jin now! Remember that!
You're remembering now, aren't you? Together, nothing stood in our way. We shaped this world together, and together, we can finish what we started.
You order the deaths of countless people. Countless Moonbloods. Moonblood sympathizers. Anyone that stood in your way!
Yes, and you carried them out. Lower your blade, old friend. First, we destroy these Moonbloods once and for all. Then I can help rid you of these fantasies that have spoiled your mind.
Just listen to me.
Cassius was my name.
That doesn't matter.
It's all that matters! All those people I killed, Fidgets. How could I possibly redeem myself in a mere few days?
You cannot, Dust. This was never about redeeming Cassius. But then, you are not Cassius.
But I share his form, his very soul.
That doesn't matter!
Why do you keep saying that?
Because you're not just Cassius! Jin didn't kill those people. Jin saved Aurora and Mudpot Village. Jin stopped Fuse, saved Lady Tethys, and now he's the only thing standing against General Gaius. Cassius would destroy the Moonbloods. But Jin, he would protect them.
No, Fidget. You're wrong. Jin didn't do any of those things.
Then you finally come to your senses.
Jin is dead, as is Cassius. Their souls now live within me, constantly reliving that fateful day. Forever in battle, forever at odds. But as long as I live, I still have a choice.
Then what are you?
I am justice incarnate, brought to this world by forces beyond your comprehension. A cleansing storm to sweep across the land and purge it of your foul presence. I am dust. And your campaign ends here, now. Throw down your weapons and surrender, or you will face an enemy unlike any this world has ever seen.
Cassius, please, don't do this. You know you cannot win.
Let's end this.
You cannot win, Cassius. You never could beat me.
Stop calling me Cassius!
There was a time when you stood by my side. We were allies once.
Not anymore, General. I'm not your ally, and I'm not your friend. Now raise your blade or drop it.
You never could scare me either, Cassius. Very well. To the death! Cassius, why would you draw your blade against your fellow soldiers? Why would you draw your blade against me?
You're destroying this world, Gaius. You and your soldiers cannot be allowed to continue your campaign.
This world belongs to the strong, Cassius. It belongs to us. Don't you remember your duty? Don't you remember your friends?
I remember everything. And it changes nothing!
Cherish it. Prepare
We did everything right, Dust. Everything we were supposed to do.
And sometimes that's not enough, Fidget. When the life threat calls. Fidget. Thank you.
Goodbye, Dust.
Through the actions of our Sen Mithrarin Dust, the Moonblood race is finally free. We will never forget his sacrifice or the deeds that saved our fairy world. We shall always remember what happened here. Dust's sacrifice will allow the Moonblood race to rise again, to rebuild our glorious civilization and live peacefully among the races of this world. Though it may appear that Dust has fallen here today, a force of good is not so easily extinguished. Sen Mithrarin was born of Dust, a current of the winds of change, a harbinger of storms yet to come.